The Todd Shapiro Show. Canada Laughs. Sirius XM 168.
Now let's focus on sort of what you're focused on here. And this week I saw that Canopy Growth announced a partnership with Greenhouse Seeds and Organibrands. And can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, so Greenhouse Seeds, you know, people may or may not know them by that name, but Strain Hunter, probably the most famous seed company out of Amsterdam. And what these guys have done is over the last 35 years, they've spent and dedicated their lives to finding strains and creating strains that were either not in the, you know, the mainstream or are brand new. And the effect of that is to become pretty globally famous, but they've always sort of been a little close to the edge. And so the first time they can actually operate in a fully federally lawful mode is in Canada, and they're doing that with us. So we put that a week ago today, and it's a big deal internationally. In Canada, it's sort of one of those things everybody's kind of sort of figuring it out now. But for our products and our patients, it's going to be pretty awesome.
And when you say figuring it out, what do you mean by that, Bruce?
Well, unless you've been through Amsterdam or up on the seed business or have watched some of the TV programs like Strain Hunter, you know, it's not the name that, you know, Tweed probably carries more visibility in the general, I'll call it Canadian public. But these guys are like internationally renowned marijuana experts in how they actually find and define and evolve strains for cannabis. And they have the, I think probably it's safe to say, the biggest catalog of types of cannabis that are unique and distinct.
Is it exciting for you and perhaps investors and just watching this company not only obviously do great things in Canada, but start to partner with, you know, so many different European companies? And we talked about the Constellation Brands deal a couple weeks ago. Just sort of really this is becoming like a massive world conglomerate.
Yeah, you know, I guess some people find conglomerate a bad word, but what we're trying to do is actually be the very best company in the world at producing and evolving cannabis into all it can be. And, that sounds grandiose for a Canadian to even think they should do that in any category. But I think, you know, we have the chance to do it in the marijuana category, and why not? You know, Canada's got the best structure. We've become the leading company in Canada doing this. And so we're trying to do kind of big stuff that maybe over the next decade people will look back and say that was pretty amazing. They achieved that.
Is conglomerate a negative connotation when it comes to big companies?
Yeah, you know, the whole marijuana is a weird, you know, it's kind of a street with a whole bunch of different kinds of traffic on it. We got the folks that are the home grow, and then we've got, us that are trying to make it so that this has become the new normal. This week had that, but we also had the federal government put out about 2 days ago, you know, what they're looking at for hearings over the next couple of months on how they can make this business platform, this product available in more and different ways. And so it's just never a dull time in the sector.
Yeah, I was reading a little bit about that as well, where the public can get involved. I think they have something like 60 days to sort of voice any concerns and stuff. So really giving an opportunity for everyone doing this together, correct?
Yeah, and it goes from like what they're calling micro grows. So if you really wanted to be like a one person business, how do you feed your product in? And all the way up to how do you do advanced medical research? And so it's a pretty broad spectrum. In the context of that, we actually put together, we think it's a good idea to have, we like the micro grows because it gives people selection. And if you have a great selection in a venue, if you're still the biggest producer, that selection draws people to look around and take a mix of the products. So I think we came up with about $1 million that we were going to put towards helping fund the micro grows. So the people who are just doing their own small business were, let us help be part of your funding and give us some of your product into the store.
Tickles Marijuana. That's my nickname. Can we do the Tickles Marijuana brand? Can we go with that?
You guys should just probably, you know, make the closet in the studio a little bit bigger. You can sneak
just start growing it
in there. It's like it's all just one big kind of linked together thing.
between the four or five guests that I have coming in and out of the studio every day, a lot of great deals could go down. I got an instant clientele.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you know, even today I was listening to the news and they're talking about the fact that the most popular thing in Canada and maybe in some U.S. states on Black Friday is what they call Instapot. And this is like this pressure cooker crossover slow cooker thing. But I think a lot of people just heard the word pot and they're all jumping in line to buy it. It's the topic. Everybody wants this stuff.
That is amazing. Yeah, you get a, like people end up with seven different pans, right? They had no idea what they're getting. It's like a pot and pan collection. It is a thing, you know.
It's maybe I'm a bad parent, but you know, this thing apparently does pressure cooking and slow cooking, and you can do all this stuff. And I have a 14-year-old. He goes, you know, really, because marijuana is going to become mainstream, they should also make it so it can help people vape at home. I'm like, okay, that's actually a really good idea, but you're 14, and I probably don't know too much about this stuff.
As long as I don't ask you for that special pot roast over the holiday season, we're fine, all right?
Exactly. It's important you teach the kids earlier, because it's always like, you know, community analogy is, a swimming pool is most dangerous for the kid who doesn't have one, right? You go to the house and fall in and you can't swim. And so I find that if you don't talk to your kids about what's going on with this stuff and why the product of the street, you know, may have been carried in the same bag as fentanyl. Maybe it got delivered by who knows who. Maybe it has whatever chemicals on it. So, you know, my kids understand it because of the business I'm in. But I think it's important, like a lot of education pushes this to the new topic.
Yeah, and at the end of the day, it really is sort of the way people would treat alcohol, where your kids would understand you'd have a glass of wine at dinner or, you know, perhaps a beer while you're watching the game. And it's like, no, kid, you got to wait till you're a little older, but understand what it's about. And just lock that cabinet, though, because kids always want to get in. So, you know, and that's sort of the same deal. Speaking of which, you mentioned microgrowers earlier. Is it sort of a good way to look at it, Bruce, for people who are kind of foreign to this game, is kind of like what a sort of a craft brewery might be?
Yeah, I think it can even be smaller than that. So a craft brewery means you still have to put a lot of cash out, right? So those guys get into, you know, heavy tanks and things. Where I think what's going to happen with the microgrow is it might be that somebody can have maybe 30 or 40 plants. And if the product needs certification and things, that there may be a way in. It's not going to be easy for them because there's still, you know, intensive testing about pesticides and things like that. But you know, the spirit of having an access point so that people who want to be part of a sector can be, isn't actually in any way threatening to us. It actually is helpful because it makes it just more conversation, more normal.
And all I'm seeing is this dream of Tickle's marijuana is totally doable. So this is awesome. I'm so excited. You can outbrand it.
I know why you have me on the show now. You just want to exploit me. I get it. This is all about Tickle.
I'm totally using you, man. You were talking about your new quest of buying a car last week because the Ford Flex isn't doing too good. And I'm sitting here in your Tweed Studios right now, live at the Gentleman's Expo, and the setup is unbelievable. Without a doubt, literally the best one here, and I'm not just saying that. And there's this car in front of me, this like 1960-odd Continental that is in immaculate condition with sweet rims. Why isn't this the car that Bruce Linton is hopping around in?
It's timely because I made it into the airport yesterday with three wheels working.
Uh-oh.
And the fourth one not. So the car is officially dead. So maybe you should see if that one's for sale because at this point I'm wheeling around in a 2006 Volkswagen station wagon. Super
Bruce,
great ride.
I'm telling you, this Tweed branded car is your car. Like this would suit you, rocking it to like I picture you listening to some old Eagles or something. What's the music of choice?
get a picture and tweet. Say, you know, send that over. Maybe text it over because I right now I'm in the market and I really probably need to make the decision in the next day because I don't think this car is going to last any longer.
Okay, this is the car. Bruce Linton's going to be rocking soon. Thanks again for the Friday update.
Thanks, guys.
Any special plans for the weekend?
Grey Cup, man.
Oh, yeah.
Canadian.
Are you going?
In Ottawa. For sure.
Oh, enjoy. I'm jealous. I was at the Argo game on last week when they won in that last-second drive. It was awesome.
Well, I'll try and cheer on one play for Toronto, but it's hard for me the rest of the game.
No problem. I understand.
Thanks,
that. Cheers. Bruce Linton, everyone, CEO of Canopy Growth Corp. Always giving us our time every Friday. I'm not quite sure if he likes that, but he does it.
The Todd Shapiro Show, Canada Laughs, Sirius XM 168.